My name's Emily Finch, and I'm a graduate student in immunology and infectious diseases. I look at how diet plays a role in disease. I'm looking at how we can use these dietary interventions to prevent cancer like leukemia. Leukemia is a disease that originates in the bone marrow, and there are these mutations. The one that we study is this chromosomal translocation that leads to the production of this Philadelphia chromosome. This is what leads to the uncontrolled growth of these tumor cells in the bone marrow. So we actually force this gene to be expressed in bone marrow. Then we harvest the LSC or the leukemia stem cells, LSC population at the core facility. And then we can do different assays with those cells by treating them with the compound of interest. The one that we look at is delta-12 prostaglandin J3. And this compound is unique because it can be derived from the body, from changes in your diet. An experimental day, you know, I'll get here around 4 or 5 in the morning to start harvesting these leukemia stem cells because I have to get them from bone marrow and then, you know, sort that from them from that population, which will take an entire day. And then after that, you know, then that's in the afternoon is when I actually can start the assays. So those can end up being, you know, 12 to 17-hour days. Well, I don't know. When I was a kid anyway, I used to always, you know, be mixing stuff up and like playing with stuff. And I sometimes feel like I get to do that every day, you know, like I get to design an experiment and then, you know, try something out. And if it works, that's awesome. Usually it does not the first time. So it just is a lot of, you know, manipulating things and getting to really, you know, understand why something didn't go well. I think that's probably my favorite part is really just getting to explore these things. And Penn State and the Huck Institutes have really been helpful. You really have all the opportunities. All the equipment is here. It's just really if you want to do it and you put your mind to it, then you really can. I also really love Penn State and love the Huck Institutes because of how interdisciplinary it is. I was a nutrition undergrad, and now I'm doing something that's taking that nutrition but then looking at how it can play a role in disease. I think that it would be a really cool thing if people could just change their diets and have their, you know, have this leukemia stem cell population eliminated. Currently, the chemotherapies will only target the bulk cells of the disease, and that means that it leads to disease relapse, and these people have to take the drug forever. Even just this year alone, there are going to be, it's estimated that there will be 50,000 new cases of leukemia, and 25,000 individuals will die of the disease. So it is a prevalent disease. And if someone could have just, you know, one round of chemotherapy and then change their diet and then survive from this disease, I think that would be a pretty cool thing. I think that what we also are studying is not just the dietary change, it's actually marketing this compound, Delta-12 PGJ3, as a pharmaceutical drug, because it does specifically target the leukemia stem cell population. And so far, we haven't seen any negative side effects of it. Whereas with the traditional therapy, there's a lot of negative side effects. They don't specifically target cancer cells. They target your healthy cells too, meaning that, you know, if you have some other sort of infection or anything else going on, your body might not be able to fight it. I'm going to be able to say that I was part of this new wave of therapy. Like I said, the targeting of a specific cell type, I think, is where we're headed in most therapies. Specifically in cancer, though, looking at the cancer stem cell population is really important. I think that if something could be made in the body, that means potentially like it wouldn't have as many negative side effects as something just formulated on a benchtop or in a tube somewhere. I think that, you know, the body is really the best machine, and that we have to try to, we're still learning so much about what it makes and how it can really, you know, be beneficial on its own. So being able to manipulate it to make the things that we want is why I think this is really cool research.